Baruch Hashem. So we are in Hilchot Shabbos in the question of can we go on a caravan in Shabbos? Okay? So what is the problem? First of all, what are we saying when we're asking about caravan? So the basic understanding of the Shulchan Aruch is talking about like caravans like with camels or horses or something like that, yeah? Shayera. Yeah, Shayera is like a trail of passengers that are going through the desert. Okay? So the Shulchan Aruch says, נצים בשיירה במדבר, הכל יודעים שהם צריכים לחלל שבת. Everybody knows when you go on a caravan into the desert that you will have to break Shabbos, right? It's almost impossible to keep Shabbos in a situation like that. כי אם פני הסכנה לא יוכלו להקר במדבר בשבת בלבד. לבדם, it's not possible for someone to like tell the whole caravan to stop for a whole Shabbat and to make a camp for like more than 24 hours. No caravan will do that. So the person will not be able to stay by himself behind. So if he's getting to that situation that is like Shabbos comes in and the caravan is still in the desert, he won't be able to just stop and park there, right? Because we're talking about like situation that the reason people went on groups is because they had all kinds of dangers, right? Wild animals, robbers, this, that, all kinds of crazy stuff. And still today there is places like that, you know, if you go in all kinds of deserts or whatever, Sahara Desert, whatever it is, you know, there's people that are doing crossing the desert. So if it is with the fast cars, whatever, so then obviously, you know, they can do it from the beginning of the week and not to get into Shabbos. Baruch Hashem. Shalom Aleichem, John. Right, but there is still this concept, even though it's not so relevant, it's not so common today that people will get into that situation, but it's possible for someone to get to that situation. Okay, so let's see what is the Shulchan Aruch is telling us. Okay, we are in Reish Memchet, paragraph Daled. Okay, so the Shulchan Aruch says, okay. So because of the fact that they will not be able to be in Shabbos without breaking Shabbos in the desert, they're not allowed to go into that journey if it is within the first, the last days of the week, meaning Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, right? If it is those last 3 days of the week before Shabbat, so then they will not be allowed to go out. But if you're talking about the beginning of the week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, so then it will be allowed to go out. And if afterwards he will have to break Shabbos because Shabbos comes in and he cannot keep Shabbos because it will be a pikuach nefesh, there is a life threat there. So he's allowed to break Shabbos because we know that there generally, whenever there is a life threat, so the principle of the Torah is v'chai b'hem, right? We have to live life with the Torah and not to give our life, right? Give over our life, except of the three severe sins, which is avodah zarah, al worshipping, shfichut damim, like killing, and arayot, idolatry, right? So anything else, right? Shabbos included, it is a life that is pushing out Shabbos. So then, Shulchan Aruch says, "En kan chilul." In a situation like that, is not called as if the person is breaking Shabbos. Okay. Va'olel Eretz Yisrael. Now, someone that is, he wants to move into the Eretz Yisrael. Okay. Bezrat Hashem, by all of Am Yisrael that are out there, that everybody will have the privilege to do Aliyah. So someone that is coming to Eretz Yisrael, in his demanalo she'era, afilu be'erev Shabbos. So imagine yourself someone that is in a situation, he wants to do Aliyah, and he have an opportunity to jump on a wagon on Friday. Yeah? That's his chance. His chance is like, you know, is that wagon, is that train, is that boat, whatever it is. You have to catch that boat, you have to catch that train, you have to catch that caravan. Otherwise, he won't be able to do Aliyah, chas v'shalom. So the Shulchan Aruch says, he's allowed to go. right? Because it's mitzvah. Because there's a mitzvah to come to Eretz Israel, even in Friday he's allowed to go in the caravan. Okay? הוא פוסק עם הם לשבות, ואם אחר שיהיו בנדבר לא יצאו לשבות, אם הוא כלל יכול ללכת עם הם חוץ לתחום פני פיקוח נפש. So then, he is telling them, when he's going with them, he's telling them, please guys, when Shabbos comes in, please let's make a break and make a camp for Shabbos. Yeah? And even though he knows in his heart, in his mind, he understands that probably they will not stop, probably they will continue to go, right? But he is allowed to go with them. He told them that he wants to make a break, he wants to make a camp for Shabbos. The fact that afterwards they are not able, they are not with him. So then he have the permission to go with them, because if he will stay by himself, he might die. So he have the permission to go with them. Okay? Now, ואם נכנס לעיר אחת בשבת, מלכת כולה, אפילו הניחו מחוץ לעיר ויוצא להיכנס לעיר מותר. Now, what about... Okay, so let's first do the Mishnah Berurah, and then we'll continue with the Shulchan Aruch. So the Mishnah Berurah, when we speak, every time we're speaking about the breaking Shabbos, so for that matter, it doesn't matter if it is rabbinical or the Oraita breaking Shabbos. Yeah, it can be something that is rabbinical, but also that, lechatchila, a person is not allowed to put himself in a situation that he will not be able to keep Shabbat, even rabbinical, right? Now, what's the difference between the first days of the week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, and the end of the week, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, for that matter? So we already explained before, previous classes, that the warning of the next Shabbat that is coming is applied to us in the 3 days before Shabbat. So that will be Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, right? But in the first days of the week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, so that we are not warned about the next Shabbat that is coming. Okay? We know the Shabbat will come, but we don't have the warning on us. So, yeah, so that's the difference. To do something that will be a problem in the next Shabbat, it must be started in the beginning of the week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. And obviously, it's very possible for someone that if he's going out early in the week, that when Shabbat comes in, he will find the situation that he will be able to keep Shabbat. You know, let's say they're coming into a little town that they can stay there for Shabbat and then to catch the next caravan that will go through the same town, for example. Yeah? It might be that he will find some kind of a solution when before Shabbat comes in, that he will be able to stop somewhere for Shabbat and he will be able to keep Shabbat, right? But when he's going out, he just went out in like a Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, so then the chances that he will have to break Shabbat is much higher, right? Mm-hmm. So that's simple. Okay, so Mishnah Berurah, Kafzayin, saying about the situation that after he went out, then he got into the situation that now he has to break Shabbat. Yeah. So the Shulchan, the Mishnah Berurah says, "Kivan imeil nisvav adavar ulevasof beones shel pikuach nefesh en kan chilul." Okay, because it was not his initiative of getting into that situation that he have to break Shabbat. Yeah, he was forced into that situation, and he have the principle of chay b'hem that he have to live with the Torah, so to keep Shabbat, and then to put someone in a situation of life threat, is not b'chay b'hem. It's not life with the Torah, right? It's death. Chas v'shalom. So therefore, it's called en kan chilul. It's not called breaking Shabbat. Okay. Upashut dekuli alma asur lo leavtiach l'sheira be'et sheishtatef imahem sheyesayam be'eze asiyat melecha b'shabbes afilu melecha derabanan af shal yedei ze itbatel nesiyah shelo. שלא ירצו להשתתף עמו, אפילו אם הוא דבר מצווה, הרי הוא מתנה בהד ילך ללדת השבס. Okay? So that's a little problem. Let's explain it. If the people of the caravan, they are telling him, look, you want to come with us? No problem. But you have to be in charge of making fire every night. Yeah? That's your job. Otherwise, we're not taking you with us. Yeah, And he says, every night? They tell him, every night. He says, but what about Shabbos? They say, we don't know what is Shabbos. You have to turn on the fire every night. Okay? So in that case, he will not be allowed to go with them, because he's going with the condition that he will break Shabbos. So he's not allowed to do that. Yeah? If he's getting in Shabbos to a situation that he have to break Shabbos to save his life or save someone else's life, so then he have the permission to do that. But to make a condition from the time that he's going out, that will be the situation that he will break Shabbos, so that is not allowed.
So it seems like the previous, what we learned before, when he gets on a ship even 3 days before, that's permitted because it's not definite that he's going to...
Also, simply, usually when someone is on a caravan, on a boat or something like that, so he's passive. He's not active doing things. Uh-huh. Yeah, there is like a crew, there is people that they are walking, they are doing things, yeah? But someone that is like on a caravan, so he's sitting on a wagon or he's sitting on a boat. He's not doing something that is like breaking Shabbos with his hands. Yeah? He's not putting like wood into the fire to keep the boat running, right? Usually that's not his job, but that's exactly the point. If they tell him that the only condition, the only way that they will take him is if he's taking the responsibility for certain thing, and they're not giving him a day off, so he will have to do it also through Shabbos, and that's the condition when they are leaving, so that then he's not allowed to live with them. He's not allowed to go with them. Okay? So that's an issue. Now the question in a situation like that, if he let's say, if he's telling them, look, I'll do it every day. And he's planning in his mind, when Shabbos will come in, I will find some kind of excuse to get out of it, and someone else will take my place. Yeah? So he told them that he will do it. But in his mind, he thinks, for this one night, when one day I will get out of it and they will find... Yeah? So in his mind, he have a reasoning to that he will be able to keep Shabbos, at least not to actively break Shabbos. So then it is better, but it's a problem with the relationship with them, yeah, because he's saying one thing and he means something else. So that's a different sin for itself. It's not about those halachot, so maybe he will have the permission to go in this way, but it's a problem that someone is saying something that he means something else. Yeah, unfortunately, most of the people in the world are doing those things today, but it's not the right thing according to the Torah, right? We have, it's called the chad v'peh, chad b'lev, one thing in the one mouth, one thing in the heart. Anyhow, that's a different sugya, Nedarim. Mishnah Berurah Kafchet, Ha'oleh le'eret Yisrael. Okay, so someone that is doing Aliyah now. Yesh emrim na'ayinu davka kedi li'teshev ba, v'yesh emrim af al menat le'achzir. Okay, so that's an interesting point. Another interesting point. When someone is doing Aliyah, so then it means that he's planning in his mind to stay in Eretz Israel forever, or it can be that he's coming to a visit in Eretz Israel. Yeah? He wants the privilege of walking Arba Amot to Eretz Israel to go to pray in the Kever David HaMelech, in the Kotel, in different places, and then he's planning in his mind to go back. Obviously, it's still a mitzvah, but even though he's not planning to stay in Eretz Israel, but is it enough of a mitzvah that he will be allowed to go out in Friday afternoon when it's known that he will break Shabbat? Okay, so that's a machloket, that's an argument, says the Mishnah Berurah. Okay, so we have two opinions here. Okay, there is an opinion that says that even if he's planning to go back, still it's enough of a mitzvah that he will be allowed to go out in Friday. Wow. Yeah? To go four steps in Eretz Israel is a mitzvah. Even without saying. Just every Arba Amot, yeah?
Every single time.
Yeah. Every time we're going to somewhere new, my family. So my wife, gave us this custom of like going like three steps and two. 1, 2, 3, mitzvah. 1, 2, 3, mitzvah. They because every four steps is another mitzvah.
Wow.
Yeah? Why not? Every four steps is every four amot is a mitzvah.
Right?
ופרט מה שהקל רמה בסוף סימן והגעה, ודאי דגם זה הוא בכלל דבר מצווה. Okay, so we have, when in the moment that we're talking about the mitzvah here, so then it is much easier, much lenient, the leniency is stronger to go out even Friday. Yeah? Mm-hmm. Even though it's you're going right into Shabbos and probably won't be able to keep Shabbos because it's a mitzvah, it's not your desire, it's Hashem's desire, right? Huh? So then you're allowed to do that. Okay, משנה ברורה כ"ט, פוסקים מהם לשבות, הפסיקה הוא לעיכובה. אם לא ירצו בזה, לא ילך עמהם. כמו שאמרתי, בערתי בירור הלכה. Okay, so again, before they're going out, he have to make a condition with them that they will camp in Shabbos. He have to make a condition with them that he will be able to keep Shabbos, somehow. Yeah? When Shabbos comes in, if it got to be a situation that you have to break Shabbos, so then you have the permission to go to break Shabbos. But when they leave, they actually have to agree with him that they will camp for Shabbos, that they will not move in Shabbos. Yeah. Even though they don't mean it, and he knows that they don't mean it, then he can still go. But if they say out, no, we are going straight, like 2 weeks straight, no breaks, yeah, all the way through. So then he's not allowed to go with him. No? Okay, obviously there's many details that can be spoken about, like what exactly was said, what exactly is their mind, you know. For example, I'm just thinking about like a practical situation. Let's say they tell him, look, our plan is to be in that city, the next city, like down the road, in Friday, and then if we get there in Friday, so then we can like stay there for Shabbos. But lemaise, practically, it's very likely that they won't get there, and they will still be in the way. So then he will have to break Shabbos. But they tell him that yeah, we'll get there and everything will be okay. Yeah, but it's not realistic because it's too much of a distance. So there is many, many, like all kinds of situations that can be occurred. Anyhow, the point is that when it's a mitzvah, there's much more leniency, right? And they have to make conditions that somehow he will be able to keep Shabbos. אם לא יכול ללכת, אם תראה להתעכב במדבר, שמה יפגשו בו חיות רעות, יפגעו בליסטים, יגזלו ממנו בהמתו, והוא לא יוכל ללכת ברגליו, יסתכן, יקחו ממנו ולא יוכל לחיות את עצמו במדבר. או שיקחו ממנו מלבושיו בזמן הקור, כולם בכלל ספק פיקוח נפש שמותר להילך עמהם. Okay, so let's say the guy, like Shabbos comes in, yeah, Friday afternoon, and they're walking. And he thinks to himself, is there really a life threat? Let's say I'm staying here by myself in the desert. So I can stop for Shabbat and continue after that in Motzei Shabbat by myself. So what really is the risk? So the Mishnah Berurah is counting the risks. Yeah. So first of all, you have like all kinds of wild animals that can be in danger for someone that is by himself. He doesn't have like someone with him that can help him. Then there is all kinds of robbers, and there is those that are even if they are not like robbers that will kill him, but they might like take his belongings, you know, his clothing, and then he will freeze to death, or his food, and he won't have food. Or his animal, and then he won't be able to cross the desert, or anything like that. It doesn't have to be a direct life threat. It can be also a threat that can lead to a life threat. And that will be enough that he will break Shabbat and not stay by himself, that he will go with them. Yeah?
משנה ברורה למד א', חוץ לתחום מועדין, אפילו חוץ ליוד ב' מיל, נמי שרי. עד שהגיע למקום שאין שם יישוב שום חשש סכנת נפשות, יפרד מהם וישבות שם. Okay.
So let's say that within Shabbos, yeah, he's going with them in like from Friday through Shabbos because they are in a place of a life threat. And then in like let's say Shabbos morning or Shabbos noon, they got to a place that there's no longer a life threat. Yeah, they got into a like a territory that is more like you know, there's people going back and forth, whatever it is. So it's not a life threat. So So then he will have to stop in the middle of Shabbos. He was going with them until that point, but when they got to that point that there's no life threat anymore, so he doesn't have permission to keep on going with them. So he will have to stop there in Shabbos itself. Yeah, even though until now he didn't keep Shabbos, but the moment there's no life threat, then he have to stop. Okay?
ואם נכנס, כיוון דבאונס יצא חוץ לתחום מפני פיקוח נפש, גם מתחילתו ברשות נפק. על כן, לא אבי כשאר יצא חוץ לתחום, דאין לו אלא דלת אמות. Okay, so then, there's a whole discussion, what do you do in a situation that somebody took you from outside of the Shabbat boundaries of the city and put you in the Shabbat boundaries of the city? Yeah, whatever, it can be a hurricane, whatever it is, but you find yourself in a Shabbat boundaries that you are not starting Shabbat there, right? In this case that we're talking about, he had the permission to go in to that territory, right, halachically, and then the moment he got into that, so now there's no threat, so he cannot keep on going, so is getting into the same box of someone that got there anywhere, anyhow, yeah, by a hurricane or who knows what. So anyone like that comes in to Shabbat boundaries, and he was not starting his Shabbat there, he have the permission to go just Arba Amot, just 2 meters around, yeah. So you have like a circle of 2 meters around him, that this is like, you have to stay in that circle for Shabbat. Oh, yeah, until Shabbat goes out.
Like as if he came out of the...
He came out of the Shabbat boundaries. He had the permission to go in. But now, when he got into the Shabbat boundaries, so there's no life threat because he's close to a city. So he cannot continue to go with the caravan. So he's getting that halachic position of someone that started his Shabbat out of the Shabbat boundaries and then he came into the Shabbat boundaries. So the halacha is that he have only Arba Amot around him. So he have like a circle of 2 meters around and he have to stay there. He cannot move anywhere. Yeah? So that's kind of a hard situation to be in, but that's the halacha. Yeah?
Arba Amot is wherever he's standing, right?
The moment he understands that he is in the Shabbat boundaries of the next city, and he understands that there's no life threat anymore, so you have to stop. He cannot continue with the caravan. And now when he stopped in the Shabbat boundaries, so you have only Arba Amot, so he cannot go out of the circle. Yeah.
Now, כתב מגן אברהם, דווקא שהלך לדבר מצווה גמורה ולא שהלך לסחורה. דאב דעת הגעה שגם זה מקרי צורך מצווה. מכל מקום, לעניין שהיה יכול להלוך בתוך כל העיר, מה שכתוב מחבר. Okay.
Now, restriction of the four amot, so really it depends what is the reasoning that he went out to that caravan. So if it was for a purpose of mitzvah, like we said, to do aliyah, or there is even those that are lenient, even if he's going on a business trip, yeah, he's going in a caravan to buy some merchandise to be able to sustain his family. Sustain your family is also mitzvah. Is it enough of a mitzvah that it will be like someone that is going on aliyah journey or something like that? So that's a machloket. Okay, that's not simple. But if you, whatever you will define as mitzvah, that you have the permission to go out on that trip, on that caravan, so if it's really mitzvah, when he's getting to the Shabbat boundaries, he doesn't have this limitation of the four amot around him. You have the permission to cross all the city and to go like through all of the Shabbat boundaries of the city, as long as he came there as a mitzvah.
Lamed Gimel, kivan elavar mitzvah. Aval im yatza mitchila ledvar reshut. Okay, so we didn't read the last part of the Shulchan Aruch. Let's go back to the Shulchan Aruch and then we'll read the Mishnah Berurah again. So the Shulchan Aruch says, אם נכנס לעיר אחת בשבס, מהלכת כולה, אפילו הנחו חוץ לעיר ורוצה להיכנס לעיר מותר. Right, so that's what I just said. He comes into a city in Shabbos,
you have the permission to go through the city, yeah, all the Shabbat boundaries of that city. And even if they leave him outside of the city, yeah, and he wants to go into the city, still is allowed because he's inside of the Shabbat boundaries, right? Okay, when the Levar Mitzvah nafak yesh lo alpayim amah lekol ruach, right? So because he have is a mitzvah person, yeah, he's going on a mitzvah journey, so then he have the permission to go 2,000 amot, which is 1 kilometer, yeah, about 1 kilometer, and the Gemara is saying that every time it says like alpayim amah, it means like the whole city is considered to be alpayim amah, even if it is a city that it will take you like 5 days to go from one side to the other, like huge cities, yeah. Still, you can go through the city, yeah, all the city.
It's one city.
It's one Shabbat domain.
Whatever
is the city size, you can go through the road. Yeah, you can walk through like a city. Yeah, I had like a situation that my wife gave birth, and I did like kiddush for her in a hospital in Shari Tzedek, and I was walking in Shabbat, like morning, like an hour and a half to get here to Kever David, to Har Tzion. Yeah, so that's, Baruch Hashem, Yerushalayim is quite a big city, but there is cities that are much, much bigger that you can go like a whole day and you won't like finish, you know?
Uh-huh.
And then you still have like a lot to go. Anyhow, that's the idea, okay? So let's see the Mishnah Berurah here. We started Lamed Gimel. So the Mishnah Berurah says, אם יצא מתחילה דבר רשות, אף על פי שהייתה, היה מותר לו ללכת עם הים חוץ לתחום מפני פיקוח נפש, מכל מקום, כיוון שעבר מתחילה דעת לכם ממה שיצא תוך 3 ימים. הרי כשאר יוצאים חוץ לתחום, דיין לו אלא 400, אם יצא קודם 3 ימים, אפילו דבר רשות, כיוון דער שאתה היה צריך לצאת מפני פיקוח נפש, יש לו 2 ימים לכל רוח, כמו ש... אוקיי. So, again, let's go over it again. The law of what will be his situation when he's getting into the Shabbat boundaries, it really depends of what was his situation when he left in this caravan. If he went with the permission, with all of the conditions that we said before, so then it is easier halachic position to deal with when he's getting into the Shabbat boundaries. So then, even though it was on a permission, not on a mitzvah, yeah, just he was fascinated to see the Sahara Desert. He doesn't go aliyah, he doesn't go to like business, whatever, he wants to go on a trip, he wants to go on a caravan, traveling. So then we said, if he's going in the beginning of the week, right, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, so then he will be allowed to go with them, right? So he's going with them with all the conditions, but it's not a mitzvah. So then there's a question. When he gets to that Shabbat domain in Shabbat, and so does he have like only the circle of the 2 meters, or he can go through the whole city? Okay, so the simple understanding of the Mishnah Berurah that he will be allowed to go through the whole city because when he went out, it was with the permission. So even though he's not a mitzvah person, still is going with the right approach, that he's listening to the halacha. He's going he have the permission halachically to be in that situation. So then he's not restricted with the 2 meters. Okay? But let's say the guy is on a mitzvah mission, yeah, he doesn't have a mitzvah that's going on. And also he didn't go in the beginning of the week, he went to in the end of the week, yeah, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, he went out. So that he didn't have the permission to go out when he left. When he left on the caravan, it was a problem. It was against halacha. He was not supposed to do that. So he did it. So now Shabbat comes in, so he have the permission to break Shabbat because he have a life thread. And then he getting into that city and he's stopping because now he doesn't have the life thread and he's wise enough to stop. So then in that situation, then he will have the full restriction of the 2 meters that he's not allowed to go out of. Yeah? Then for sure you will have that restriction. That's what the Mishnah Berurah says. Now, let's read the Ramah. Okay, the Ramah in the end of the Siman, and that will be the end of the Siman. Bezrat Hashem. Yesh omrim shekol makom she'adam olech, nisrora lirot pnei chavero, chashuv dvar, hakol dvar mitzvah. Okay, so now the Rama is dealing with that question of what is a mitzvah? Yeah, what does it call mitzvah journey? When you're going on a trip, so what can you have in mind? Okay, so let's say you're visiting your friend, yeah? You're going to visit your friend. Obviously, if you're going to visit your mother or father, that's for sure mitzvah. Kibud avem. But let's say you're going to visit a friend. So says the Mishnah Berurah, even that can be considered to be a mitzvah, yeah? To have like to give someone joy by visiting him, you know? There is people that are dying because of loneliness, you know? Especially today in our generation with all of the situation that people are restricted and they're not leaving their houses. There is people that they don't have anyone visiting them and they're dying in their houses, yeah? So to go to visit someone, you can save his life, right? Today. So today, for sure, it's a mitzvah in our generation. But anyhow, that's what the Rama is saying, right? It's like a Ruach HaKodesh of the Rama. I don't think that they had those situations in their time, but maybe. Anyhow, it says, Eino chashuv dvar reshut rak sheolech letayel. So what will be something that is not a mitzvah, according to that? Yeah, it seems that the concept of a mitzvah is so wide, you can fit anything in. Yeah, anything can be considered to be a mitzvah. So when he's just going on a trip, just is curious to see the Sahara Desert, like I said, or whatever it is, the Grand Canyon, whatever it is. Yeah, he's just curious. He wants to see. He wants to see the nature. So then, this is reshut. This is not mitzvah. Okay. But even that, you can find a way to say that it is mitzvah. For example, if I know a rabbi. Okay, I won't say his name because maybe he doesn't want people to know. But I know a rabbi that is going on a ski vacations, yeah. Whatever, when he have the money, he is going on a ski vacation. And one time I spoke with him, and I heard from him why he's going on a ski vacation. He said, when I'm standing on the top of a mountain that is like snowy, and I looking on like the wonders of the creation, I feel Hashem. I can feel I can connect to Hashem. When I'm going on those vacations, I'm like I have like all the nature like in front of me. Then I feel that I can connect to Hashem. That's my way to experience that connection. So someone like that's what he needs to connect to Hashem. That's what he needs to feel is close to Hashem. Okay, so it might be a mitzvah even just to go on a trip to see the nature. Yeah, I think there's more than a few people in the world that they feel Hashem more in when they're going out to a nature. I think that's even people that they don't know what's the reason, but I think most of the people that they're going on all kinds of trips of, you know, hiking and whatever, I think that's what stands behind it. Even many of them don't aware of that, but that's my understanding. Anyhow. Yeah, that's for prayer. Okay, what you're saying, maybe it's another interesting question. It will depend with who you're asking to go on a Kivrei Tzadikim trip. Oh. You know, there's many Jews that are going like all kinds of places in the world to visit like Kivrei Tzadikim, like tombs of righteous people. So is that a mitzvah or it's not mitzvah? You don't have a like obligation now to go to the tomb of Rabbi Yaakov Abu Chatzira. Okay? It might be an interesting journey. Yeah, it might give you a lot of inspiration to go there, but you don't have a mitzvah, you don't have an obligation. Yeah? So someone that is going on a caravan into Egypt to visit the tomb of Rabbi Yaakov Abu Chatzira. So for many people, it will be considered to be a mitzvah. So it really depends also like who is your rabbi and what is your hashkafa and like how to relate to that. But whatever it is that you define as a mitzvah, if that's the case, so then you have all the privilege of like when you're getting into a city to go through all the city, right? That was the segment that we're dealing with. So let's just finish the Rama here. וכן נהגו בקצת מקומות להקל בהפלגת הספינות והליכת שיירה תוך שלושה ימים, כי חושבים הכל לדבר מצווה ואין למחות בידן הועיל ויש שלהם על מי שיסמוכו. So the Rama is concluding that even though there is many people that are lenient about going on a sail, going on a caravan, all kinds of situations like that, even in Friday, 3 days before Shabbat, still there is people going out. How come? So the answer is that they consider that to be a mitzvah and they have what to rely on. So, okay.
So let's see the Mishnah Berurah. Okay? למד ד' זכורה אפילו יש לו מזונות ולא זכורה להרווחה לגבות מאוד מינו יהודי שהוא חולה כל זמן שאינו גוסס לא מקריא פסדה ודאית ואלי הרב המקל בזה ורמה הולך לזכורה על כן אוקיי
So again, you have all kinds of discussions when someone is going on a business trip. So how sure you are that you're actually going to make money in that trip? Yeah? If you really need that money, you have children and wife that you need to feed, and you know that if you go on that trip so you can make that money that you need to sustain them, so far, okay, fine, that's really mitzvah. But let's say someone is going on a trip that maybe will meet someone that maybe will give him money, yeah? So that's too many maybes. It's not a real mitzvah. It's not for sure. You cannot say, for sure I'm coming back with money that I can sustain my family. So then you don't have the permission to go out, okay? But there is different opinions. There is lenient opinions. But that's what the Mishnah Berurah says. צורה, כן, הליכת שערה, דעת כמה מגן אברהם כמה מזוקים, הליכת שערה אין להקל. אין נוחות במקום שלא נהגו להקל, אין כדאי לכתחילה להקל. Okay, so the Mishnah Berurah is saying that there is a difference between going on a sail and going on a caravan. The going on a sail, so it's more like comfortable to think that a person will not have to like really break Shabbat with his hands to do something. Usually people that are passengers on a ship, so they are passive, they're not doing anything, right? So then it's easier to keep Shabbat. But to go on a caravan, especially if someone is driving, for sure, but yeah, going on a caravan, so there's a much higher risk that you will have to break Shabbat. So the Mishnah Berurah is making that differentiation, first of all. And secondly, he's saying that what the Rama says is if you are in a place that the custom is to be lenient, you can be lenient and rely on the lenient opinion. But if you are in a place that the custom is not to be lenient, and you say, but I want to be lenient, I want to rely on those lenient opinions. So then the Mishnah Berurah says, no, don't do it. Don't do it. If you are in a place that this is the custom, so you can keep that custom. You can act according to the custom. But if not, so don't do it. Okay, so Baruch Hashem, we finished the Siman Reish Mem Chet, and Bezrat Hashem Bli Neder, tomorrow we will continue with Reish Mem Tet. For now, we'll hold it here. Thank you very much. Bracha v'atzlacha, and Bezrat Hashem will have the privilege that all of Am Yisrael will keep Shabbat together. And we know we have a promise that Mashiach is coming, the redemption is coming, everything is coming. Bezrat Hashem soon, amen k'nei ratzon.